Hi there. Welcome back to the three things you need to know in the news for September 17, 2022. This current news podcast is brought to you from the desk of your favorite phonetician, my uncle Dony Sanan, at the Technolinguistic Temple. Let's begin. 1. Uber Technologies and a subsidiary have submitted a payment of $100 million to the New Jersey Department of Labor and Workforce Development after several audits found the rideshare company improperly classified hundreds of thousands of drivers as independent contractors. State Labor Commissioner Rob Acero-Angelo said this meant Uber drivers were deprived of crucial safety net benefits. They were being denied many different rights that come with being an employee, whether it be minimum wage, overtime, but more important for this audit, contributions into the unemployment trust fund, temporary disability, family leave, he said. The $100 million payment to New Jersey's unemployment insurance fund follows a series of audits performed by the Department of Labor between 2014 and 2018 that assessed Uber and subsidiary Razier, a combined $78 million in past due contributions plus penalties and interest of $22 million. 2. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky has been involved in a car accident, his spokesman has revealed. On Wednesday, September 14, 2022, a passenger car collided with the presidential vehicle and his escort in the capital Kyiv, Sergei Nikiforov said in a short statement. The president was examined by a doctor, no serious injuries were found, he said. This comes after President Zelensky, 44, visited the recaptured city of Izium, a key logistics hub in northeastern Ukraine. The driver of the car that collided with the motorcade was treated at the scene and driven away in an ambulance. And finally, former U.S. President Donald Trump said Vladimir Putin's invasion of Ukraine could ultimately lead to World War III. What happened? Ultimately, could be a World War III, Trump said in an interview with India's NDTV, as he added that the Kremlin would have never invaded Ukraine if he had been the president. President Putin would have never gotten in if I was president. Never. Not even a chance, he said. That's all for today. Please stay tuned for tomorrow's current events, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel, Modern Languages for All. Take care, and have a nice day.